to tell you some things tonight, and we're going to have something cool. Now, does anybody know what all this stuff is up here?
Wood.
Yeah, but what do you think it's for?
Fire.
What kind of fire?
Like a fire pit, and maybe...
We're going to roast marshmallows?
Yeah!
Oh.
Yeah. Oh!
What?
Will the people sin, and then they have to kill a sheep?
That's pretty good. You know what that's called?
Sacrifice.
A sacrifice. How'd you know that?
I saw the sheep.
Yeah, that's kind of a small sheep. Anyway, yeah, it's a sacrifice. Well, God designed that plan for people to make a sacrifice, like you just said, to atone for sin. See, it was before Jesus ever came. Jesus was a sacrifice, and he was a type of the lamb that was sacrificed on the cross. But now, the children of Israel, does anybody know who that is? No, the children of Israel. Does anybody know who they are?
Israel?
No, not quite.
Israelites.
They're people, they're God's people. They're the ones he called to be his people. And the Bible calls them children of Israel. You see, when you belong to God, you're one of his children. And so they are the children of Israel. Well, we're not going to go into that tonight, but the whole thing that God would have to sacrifice. Well, let me tell you what happened. These children of Israel, God told them, don't ever bow down to another god. Does anybody know about the Ten Commandments? What's one of them?
James.
No, that's the disciples.
No, that,
Tonight's
that's right. That's one. Can anybody think of one that God says?
Don't sin.
That's one right there. What?
Do not worship.
There it is. Do not worship. Don't worship any other god before me. But no other god before me, the Bible says. Well, what had happened? God's people, which are called
Israelites,
and what else?
Children of God.
Children of God. Children of Israel. There you go. The children of Israel, they were supposed to be worshiping only God because God said so. And what did he tell them not to do? Worship the false god. Worship another god. Right. Any other god besides the God of heaven is a false god. He's a false idol. Well, let me tell you what they did. They got out there on their own, and they started thinking that they knew more than God did. And then they had this awful, mean, wicked king that got up and was in charge of everybody. Does anybody know what a king does? What? He tells people what to do. He's like a ruler over the people. So what he says goes. Well, they got a terrible, awful, wicked king up there. Does anybody know any of the king's names in the Bible?
God?
Oh,
I think it's King James.
David.
David was a king. He was the king of Israel. There was Saul. There was a whole bunch of kings of Israel. Well, this one particular king was not a good king. And he is in our Bibles in 1 Kings. Now, I want to read you something real fast, and then I'm going to tell you something that's going to knock your shoes off. Are we ready? Listen to this. There was a king in Israel, and his name was not David. It was not Saul. It was not God or Jesus. It wasn't any of those. But his name was Ahab. Anybody ever heard that name?
No!
You have? You've not, but you two have?
I have.
Do you know anything about him?
He was a very, very, very mean king.
He was mean.
That's right. He was a mean king. A wicked king. Y'all know.
He's a bad, rich king.
Bad, yeah. He was real bad. And his name was Ahab. You know what I like to call him? Don't tell him this, but here's what I call him. Ahab the Arab. That's what I call him. No, not the bunny. He's a mean, wicked king. Well, let me tell you what he did. He got up on his throne, and you remember he's supposed to be God's king?
Yeah.
He's ruling over God's people. He's supposed to be saying what God says to do. And you know what he did? He says, don't listen to the God of heaven. He don't know what he's talking about.
He doesn't even know a thing what he's even saying.
That's right. You know what he did? He said, I've got another God I want you to worship.
If he wants them to worship another god, what does that mean he's wanting them to do?
Worship a false god.
And you know what that false god's name was?
The dude was
called
Baal. And he was a false god. He was not a real god. So, all right, you guys ready? Listen to this. It's going to get you. This false god named Baal never did anything. First of all, they couldn't see him. They couldn't hear him. He never performed a miracle. He never did anything for them. But yet, they always went and worshipped him with terrible ways of worship. What?
That's absolutely the opposite of what they do with God.
That's right.
And what God does.
He's the opposite of God. What?
They're worshiping a false god.
They're worshiping a false god. What?
Does he do backflips?
He doesn't even do backflips because he's not even a real god. He can't do anything. All right, so here's what happens. So he's got him up here and he says, now you're going to worship this false god. And so they all come in there and they're worshiping this false god named Baal, and it's crazy. Well, out of nowhere, there comes a man, and he is one of God's men. And he comes to the palace where old Ahab is. Ahab's sitting up on his throne and he thinks he's got it made. He's telling everybody to do everything. You know, he's like, hey, you do this. Hey, you do that. Hey, worship Baal. And he's giving them all these orders. And all of a sudden, this man of God, his name is Elijah. Elijah. He's our first hero of the Bible in our Bible school. What?
He was the first and second one on the earth.
Well, he was a prophet. He was a prophet sent by God. And you know what God sent him here to do? What?
To be nice, but he didn't.
No.
To be like a missionary.
He was a type of missionary. Anybody
he called people to do right things. And
he did. That's what God had him do. He came down. God had sent a prophet down here to tell them what would happen if they didn't do the right thing. Well, he come down and he busted into the palace of the king. And he walked straight in through there, through all guards, didn't care what anybody said to him, walked right up to the king, pointed his finger at his face, and he said, King, because of your sins, because of what you've done to God's people, God is not going to allow the rain to fall on this land until I come back and tell you he's going to. And Elijah turned around and walked out of the palace that day. You know what the king did?
Tell him to come back.
You think he ignored him?
Yeah, I think he would.
Yeah, I think the king probably said.
He left.
I think he would leave me alone and you're not the boss of me.
Right. Because that's the way kings are, right? So he don't listen to Elijah. He's not going to change his ways. And you know what? King Ahab got mad about it. And so he decided to send some men to try to find Elijah and take care of him. Yes. So he sent people out to look for him. Well, God took care of Elijah. God loved Elijah. He's sitting there. He's his prophet. So he takes him and hides him for a while all the evil men are looking for him. Well, finally, it comes and God stops all the rain in the land. You know what happens when you have no rain?
Drought.
All the plants die,
all your food's gone.
And your house, your plants would grow, and your plants wouldn't be, the animals wouldn't have water.
Right.
And you wouldn't have trees to give you energy.
That's right. So there's no rain, there's no trees, there's no grass, there's no water, there's no animals can't live, you don't have any food, and you begin miserable and sick, and everybody starts dying, and it's terrible.
And the wood is gone with people.
So all the people then are dying off, and it's getting bad. And this happened for 3.5 years. Can you imagine not having any water for that long? Okay, so now, if we think about it, we think, well, those people are crazy. Why didn't they just do what God said and let it rain, and then God would send the rain back? But you know what? They kept saying, we're not listening to the God of heaven because we worship Baal. And so they kept praying to Baal. Baal, make it rain. Baal, make it rain. And it wouldn't rain.
Baal can't make it rain.
Right.
Baal can't do anything.
Because God's the one who makes the stuff do it.
That's right.
Because he's the one who made the world.
Exactly. So God made the world. God makes it rain. Baal has nothing to do with it.
Because he's not God.
That's right. So God has not gave him any rain now for all this time. And then he tells Elijah, he says, hey, go back out and face the king. And here's what happened. Listen to this. In verse 17 of 1 Kings 18, the Bible says, and it came to pass when Ahab saw Elijah, that Ahab, now remember who Ahab is?
Well, the evil king.
The evil king.
The evil king. And who's Elijah? The prophet of God. And he's our what? What's our theme? He's our hero. So our hero comes to meet him, and they come to meet face to face in the desert. And it's dry, and they're walking through there. Have y'all ever seen those old westerns on TV when the cowboys come walking toward each other?
Yeah.
And they're ready to draw their guns?
Yeah.
Well, that's kind of what it was like. Here come Elijah on one side. He's the man of God. And boy, he's got God on his side. He's walking toward him. And Ahab's coming the other way. And Ahab thinks he knows everything because he's the king. And so they're coming face to face for a battle royale. Does anybody know what that is?
A battle.
Like you had last year with the soldiers.
That's right. We had the Lord's army last year, didn't we?
Yeah.
All right. So they come face to face like it's going to be a huge battle. And Ahab told this to Elijah. He said, are you that one that keeps troubling Israel? So the king blames the prophet Elijah for all the problems going on. Can you believe that? When it's Ahab's problem to begin with, he's the one that caused it. Now, what kind of crazy thing is that? But listen to what our hero, Elijah, told him back. He says, and he answered, I've not troubled Israel, but you have. You're the dirty buzzard that's done this.
What? Because he's the bad person.
That's right. He's like, it wasn't me, Ahab, yo Arab. I didn't do it. You did it. You're the one doing all the bad things.
You're the one that's coming against God.
That's right. And here's his exact words. He answered, I've not troubled Israel, but thou and thy father's house, and that you have forsaken the commandments of the Lord, and thou hast followed Baal. And so, now they're coming to meet. Can you imagine what the king thought about that? You're accusing me of doing this? You're the one that came into my palace and said it wasn't going to rain, and here you're coming and blaming me for it? And so he gets very upset. What?
It was his fault.
What?
And then God said, why blame it on me? You don't
want to
do it.
All right. So Elijah didn't do it, but Ahab did. So Elijah said, okay, I'll tell you what, king. He said, I'm going to take the cuffs off now. And you know what he does? Here's what he does. He says, okay, if you're so smart, and if your God is so big, and your God is so powerful, and he can do all these things you claim he can do, and all this, he said, I want you to start praying to your God, Baal. Start praying, get all your men to pray. Start praying and ask him to, and he said, we're going to set up a sacrifice. You sacrifice on one to your God named Baal. I want you to build your sacrifice. And here's what he said, and I want you to go first. I'm going to give you the benefit of the doubt. You build your altar, and then I'm going to build one, and we're going to see whose God is real. And whoever's God is real will consume the sacrifice. So watch this. Here's what happened. So those old guys, let me move this flag out of the way. So those old guys that were worshiping Baal, they start building an altar. So here's what they build an altar. Somebody come here and help me. Come on. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to arrange these bricks, and we're going to arrange them around in a circle so we can put some wood in the middle of it.
They won't really.
That's okay. That's okay. It'll be close enough. Put another one over there. All right, now let's get one of those logs. Get one of those logs and put it in the middle. There you go.
Okay.
Yeah, it's
All right, now here is their sacrifice. So it goes on the altar. Okay? So lay it on the altar, however it can go. There you go. Perfect. All right, now go ahead and be seated. So here's what they all did. Those old crazy guys that were worshiping this Baal, they built an altar. And then they started praying. Oh, and they got down. Oh, Baal, hear us. Baal, hear us. Save us. Send and burn the sacrifice. Oh, Baal. And the Bible says they did this all morning and all afternoon. They kept on and on. And it said that Baal never answered. And Elijah, you know what Elijah did? He was sitting over to the side watching. And he was going, scream a little louder. Perhaps your God is on vacation, is what he was telling. Perhaps that he's talking to someone who can't hear you. And so he's making fun of them the whole time. And that's making him mad. And they keep on and on. Baal, please hear us. And you know what the Bible said they did to themselves? They started getting knives and things and cutting their arms and their legs, cutting themselves up to bleed because they thought that would make Baal answer them. And so you know what they were doing? All these guys were running around like crazy. And they were bleeding and cutting themselves and screaming and falling on the ground and praying out loud and everything. And Baal never did anything. Why not?
Can't do anything because he's fake.
He's fake.
Because he's not nice and he doesn't do anything for anybody.
He's not. He can't. He can't do nothing. He can't do nothing because he's not even real. So Elijah watches all this go on. And he says, look, guys. It's just not going to work out for you. I'm sorry, but apparently your God is gone on vacation or something. So here's what we're going to do. I'm going to build an altar. And I'm going to build it to my God. Now you sit back and you watch. So here's what he did. He started out. Somebody, I need somebody to help me here. All right. Yeah, you're a good strong. Now what we got to do, these are heavy. Can you pick it up? All right, so we're going to put these around the altar, and I want you to stand that one up right there. There you go. And we get another one. I'll put this one up. You get the next one. You get this one. And they go like this. Put that there. That one goes. Let's see. Put that there. And the next one goes in there. The other way. Yeah, that one stands up that way. Good job. This one next. You doing okay? There you go. You got it? Be careful now. Those things are heavy. Here's what the prophet Elijah said. He built himself an altar to God. Can anybody see the names on these stones?
I see Dan.
What's that?
Dan.
Okay.
Here's Ephraim. Can anybody tell me who these names belong to?
People.
The people up there.
They're up there now, yes.
Are they? 12 tribes of Israel.
The 12 tribes.
The 12 tribes of Israel. Now, what that means, that's the sons of the man that God named Israel. Okay? So, these are his sons' names. Dan, Reuben, Asher, Judah, Gad, Simeon, Issachar, Naphtali, Ephraim, Zebulun, Manasseh, Benjamin, and Asher, and Reuben, Dan. So those are the 12 tribes of Israel. And this is what the prophet Elijah set up. This was a sacrifice to God, and he's including the children of Israel because this is the people he's preaching to. The people that came from these tribes. They were children of Israel, remember? All right, so this is the tribes that come from. So he sets up his altar. Then he puts on the wood. And he piles up his wood real good. Gets it up here. And the whole time, you know these guys up here, they're worn out, but they're probably laughing at him saying, that's never going to work. And so they think he's ready. They think this is it. He says, oh, hold on a minute now. And he puts his sacrifice on there. And then, just when you think that he's done, you know what he says? Wait a minute, guys. Stop right here. Your God didn't answer you. He didn't burn up your sacrifice. I've not prayed to mine yet for this one. And I tell you what, just to make things fair and to prove that my God is the greatest, go get some water and pour on this. So they start bringing barrels of water. Oh, and they're pouring it all down into the trench here. And they're soaking it. And they're putting it all in here. Getting all over the sacrifice, the altar. And they start pouring it on the sacrifice. And they say, there you are. Okay, Elijah, it's wet. He says, no, not wet enough. Go back and get some more. And they think he's crazy. And so they go back and get some more. And they keep on. And he says, pour it on there. Get it wet. Get that sacrifice good and wet. We don't want anybody to think that it just accidentally caught on fire. And they keep on and on and on pouring water on the sacrifice. I mean, they soaked that thing down to where it is running and running all over the place. And so now it's done. It is soaking wet. Now what? What do you think is going to happen? Let's take just a second. See what the Bible says. Verse 31 said, Elijah took the 12 stones. He put them according to the number of the tribes of the son of Jacob, Israel, unto whom the word of the Lord came, saying, Israel shall be thy name. He built the altar, put the stones, and then he told them to fill the barrels of water, pour it on the burnt sacrifice, to do it a second time and a third time. And the water ran all around the altar and filled the trench with water. And it came to pass at the time of the offering of the evening sacrifice, Elijah the prophet came near and said, Lord God of Abraham, Isaac, of Israel, let it be known this day that thou art God in Israel, that I am thy servant, and that I have done all these things at thy word. And then he says, hear me, O Lord, hear me, that this people may know that thou art Lord and God, and that thou hast turned their heart back again. So he's praying. He prayed. He didn't go crazy. He didn't cut himself. He didn't scream and holler, but he prayed, and you know what happened when he said, let them know that you're the true God. You know what happened? Anybody know? I'll tell you what happened. All of a sudden, fire fell down from heaven, and it went all over the sacrifice, and it came down, and the fire was pouring down all over it, and it started burning the sacrifice, and it burned up all the water in there, and it came all down through there, and boy, it was just all over that sacrifice. And Elijah stood there and he looked up at God like this. And he says, now the people's going to know that thou art the true God. And you know what the people did that was standing around watching? Here's what they did. They fell down on their face. And they said, thou art the true God, the God of heaven, the God of the children of Israel, the God of Elijah. He's the true God. And they laid on their face and they cried and they repented and said, God, we're sorry for causing all these problems and worshiping these false idols of Baal. And God, we know that you're the true God now. And they realize that he is the true God of heaven,
Because he came through and burned up that sacrifice. Now, can anybody tell me the difference between this God and this one? What?
That one's bigger, and that one's little, and that one's on fire.
This was the real God, the God of heaven, the one that sent his son. Did anybody know what his son's name was?
Jesus.
Jesus. What did Jesus do?
Oh, died on the cross.
That's right.
Died on the cross to save our sins.
That's right. He died on the cross to save us from our sins. So what does that mean? God that we're sinners. What did these old awful people over here need to do? They returned as his people for that time.